Hello student, welcome to my class of computer science for 11th class. Today we'll understand the following content, which are as follow. The first one, what is error, in which we'll understand its definition. Second one thing, types of error. Third one thing, there are different type and its explanation along with its example, like syntax error, runtime error, and logical error. And fourth one thing, how to handling with the exception handling, okay? And the fifth one thing, that is homework and practical assignment for the day. So let's begin, student. So first topic, according to our content, what is error? Actually, student, error is a message given to the user who use the computer, okay, by the computer, that state that something going to be wrong or committed by system or user. So error can be generated through a user also and system, it means to say machine also, okay. In other words, we can say that an error is described an issue, okay, that arises unexpectedly done by the computer or not functioning any function properly by the computer or the program codes, okay. So this particular thing is in count as a error, okay, that can be hardware error or the software error or the user error also. So now we have to understand what are the different type of the errors. So basically there are three type of error, which are as follow, student. The first one thing, syntax error. Second one thing, that is logical error. And last, we will continue, that is runtime error, student. So one by one, I will continue that one thing. So first one thing is syntax error. So syntax, as you know, student, the grammar of the language of the programming language in which we have to know how to write the code and how to explain it, okay, how to declare it, how to define it, and how to use it, okay. So syntax error are the most basic type of error, okay, student. Whenever you are new for the programming language, this particular error you will face many times, okay. So this type of error is basic type of error that arises when the Python parser is unable to understand the line of code. That means to say, there is some program inside the Python language or the programming language that is known as parser, and parser actually need to understand the every line of code and even then the token also. As you remember, student, we have learned the token, that is character, numbers, alphabets, space, white space, etc. These are the categorized under the tokens. Okay, student, like data type. Okay. So these are the tokens. So parser actually understand the particular token by token content. If it is not able to understand the particular code, so that time syntax error is occur. Okay. So syntax error are most always fatal, okay. That means to say, you are need to check that where the error is done, okay. For example, you have written print, misspelled print, okay. So that time you have to check that and you have to rectify that, otherwise it will not run again. So it mean to say, syntax error are most always, okay, fatal errors. Now you can see the example here, student. Here is evil, within that round bracket open, double quote close, and round bracket close. This is rare, okay. Here is ideally actually highlight the particular error in the most syntax error, okay, and indentation, okay, incorrect argument, okay. If you will get the error, you will see what will happen. So student, I will show you what is the example of that. So here you can see, student, the syntax error example. So here you can see in first line, student, in the first line, print is written is good, round bracket is open is also correct. Here is double quote open and single quote close, so this will be also cause the error, okay. So to do that, student, we are going to the open the Python IDLE, okay, and we are going to open a file. So I will provide here a command, that is a program for error. For which error? Syntax error. Now I am going to do the same thing, that is, for example, print within round bracket, I will put the particular double quote, and here I am going to type hello. Okay, and single quote close. Now if I'm going to run it, so file name, suppose that e1, okay, or suppose that e2, because I already created. So now you can see that there is error in your program EOL. That's mean end of line code is problem. Okay, so what you have to do, student, to rectify it, you have to double code it and then run it. So this is fatal error. It meant to say syntax error are totally fatal. We can't rectify it. Okay, we can rectify it with the help of only editing the code only. Okay, that meant to say fatal. The next one example, that is here you can see that capital P is written here along with that particular spelling is not correct. Even the double quote is proper. So what I am going to do, student? So I am doing the same thing. PTRN. Within that, if I am going to just providing hello. Okay. Then after that, I am running this. So what will happen? So here you can see that name error will be come here. Okay. It says PTRN is not defined because PTRN is considered as a variable here. So to rectify that one thing, you have to just type print. Even you are going to just write the capital P, it will not recognize your particular code. Why? Because Python is highly case sensitive language. Okay, student. So now you can see that I can easily print it. Now we are going to understand the next one type of next one way to create the error, syntax error. For example, here x equals to 9, y equals to 0. So I'm going to just assign this like such way. So what I will do, student, to do that, suppose that x equals to none and y equals to suppose that 90, and I'm going to just do one thing, that is x plus y equals to suppose that 80. So let's see what will the output. Here you can see that there is error in your program. What is that? The can't assign the operator. Why? Because always assignment from this way. Okay, not like this way. X plus y will not store to 80, while 80 will store to x. So I will make it comment, okay, or I can delete it. So now you can see that it will be easily run. Okay, next one thing, I'm going to print k directly. So what will happen? The name error will produce here by the compiler, or sorry, by the interpreter. So here k, it will say there is no such k type of variable is defined. That means to say name error. It is also a type of the syntax error. So to rectify that, I have to declare a k at least by any value or something else. Okay, then run it. So now you can see 90 will print here. Okay, and now I am going to do this one thing. Print equals to 12. It will be also a error. So how it is possible? Suppose that print equals to 12. Okay, or I will do one thing. Like this way. So what will happen, student? So it will say there is non-equal. Okay, so you have to rectify that one thing. And another one thing we'll talk about, this one thing, last one type, that is z equals to r, and we are going to typecast it with incorrect way. This is syntax error. So here example, z equals to simple within quote r, capital or small, it's up to you, and then we are going to typecast it with incorrect way. No need to just type the correct way, you have to type incorrectly and then run it. So now you can see that there is error in your program. Why? Because I am not using this particular, okay, in a which way, in a systematic way. Even you can just print it like this within round bracket. Okay, let's see what will happen. Again error, because it is incorrect way. Now we can go to the logical error, student. What is logical error? Actually, logical error is a most difficult type of error to find, to detect. Okay, because the logic will be wrong, message will be different. Okay, in a such way, user need to use the debugger program. Debugger means by self death checking process, it is known. Okay, by which programmer check the line by line code whether he had committed the problem error, because it is not easily caught by system or the interpreter, okay, of the language. So it is actually very difficult to fix the problem. So let's see what is the example. So here is example of logical error. For example, x equals to 90 and y equals to 20, And in hash, I am to say comment I have pasted here, operation regarding to comparison of x and y. We will discuss in later student, but we can consider it is, okay? And you have written there a message, wrong message, y is greater than x, but it is not possible, you can see, okay? Compiler just easily compile it and just print it. Compiler doesn't know what you have typed, what is the meaning of that one thing inside the double quote of printing, okay? So that's why it is very difficult to calculate, I'm say catch by the interpreter, and programmer need to debug it, okay student? So here you can say both variable x and y equal, but here is different one. Or we can see that the total, where you can see that if we are going to total, I'm to say it's addition then, and message is different, the total value of x and y is x minus y. So let's do it practically, student. So now I'm going to open a Python. Inside that, a comment or logical error program. Okay, student, here is suppose that x equals to 90, y equals to 20, and some comparison, or I will show you the third one. So I'm going to print message will be like the total of variable a and not a and v, x and y is, you can see here I'm just going to perform the subtraction operation, okay? That is wrong. So here is e3. Now you can see the total of variable x and y is 70, where the value of x and y are 20. So it is really difficult to identify that. Why? Because programmer type the number of the code, okay, in a program. Here is only three lines, that's why we can easily detect it. Suppose the programmer need to type the 500 line of code to perform the to create the program, he or she cannot easily get that problem, okay? So logical error really difficult to rectify. Next one thing, exception or runtime error. So student, first of all we have to understand what is runtime error. When a program arise the error, okay, at the time of running of code is known as runtime error, okay? You can say that if you have asked the user, okay, to enter the value, to divide a value, okay, that time user enter 0 and whatever number divided by 0 will be always infinity, that is termed as error in a computer, okay? That is runtime error, because program is okay, output is also okay, but the processor time, the error is generated, okay, by the user, okay, or the some kind of system, or you can say that hardware disabilities, okay? So that time is termed as runtime error. So we can learn, student, exception arise when the Python parser knows what to do or piece of code but unable to perform the action. An example would you trying to access the internet with a Python without internet connection. The Python interpreter knows what to do and command with that command and unable to perform it. Example, zero division error, and it is also type of runtime error. So student, in above particular explanation, suppose that if you have created a particular program with the help of internet connectivity, we can perform that, okay? And we are just using that particular application without internet, such time the error will be generated. It says internet connection error. Okay, because software doesn't have the prior knowledge whether the internet is existence or not, okay? So it will be decided by runtime, I'm to say execution time of program. So it is termed as runtime error, and sometime it is also known as exceptions. So let's see the example, student. Here you can see that here is a variable a equals to 90, okay, and we have asked the user to enter the value in variable b, okay? So it is for Python 2.7, okay, and the next one line is for 3.0 plus version, okay? So suppose that user entered the value is 0, okay, that is unknown by user or software. So that time this expression will be executed or evaluated, c equals to a upon d, this cause error, that is exception, and this message will never print. So let's do it practically, student. So how to do that? We have to open a particular Python. and then we will open a file, a program for exception. Okay, student. Suppose that here is a equals to 90 and we have asked the user to enter the value. Okay, so first of all I will typecast it integer. Okay, and raw input. So here, please enter a number. Okay, student. And in this we have said that c equals to a upon b, and at last we have print message that is the value of what c is, then c. We are going to save it, student. That is expression 4. Here it will show you the message. If you have entered 2 or 3, that will be okay, there is no problem. But if user enter the 0, so now you can see error has been occurred. This particular error known as runtime error or exception. Here you can see there is no problem in this code, and in earlier execution of program there was no problem. But in a situation when user enters 0, that time error generated. Okay, so this means to say integer division or modulo by 0 error. Okay, to overcome this problem we need to understand exception handling, which is also known as dealing with runtime error. Okay, student. So we have to understand what is exception handling. So unlike the syntax error, exception are not always fatal. It means to say we can rectify it. Okay, exception can be handled with the use of a try statement. Okay, here is you can see that try statement is very important. Okay, consider the following example. Suppose that we are going to open a HTML page, okay, website like example.com. okay, with execution of program, reach try to statement, okay, and attempt to perform the indent code following. If the some of the reason there is no an error, the computer not connected that particular internet pages, okay, or Python interpreter, it will jump to the intended code below to the exception of command. Okay, so it means to say, student, it will be consider the example. Suppose that in this particular try, okay, in try particular, this is try exception block, okay, try except block. In this particular area we will place a sensitive code in which we can consider the user can give the such type of value which is perform the error. Okay, okay, student. In such case we have to place the sensitive code here, okay, which may arise the error. Okay, and then after that except is another particular keyword of try block. Okay, and then inside that we will place here a error type, because number of error type are also there inside the exception handling. Okay, here is value error. Okay, sometime it may be a device zero error also, page not found error also, no internet connection error also. Okay, so we will discuss in next video in depth, but I'm going to tell you what is exception handling and how to perform it. We will focus on this one thing. Okay, student. So here you can see that age has been asked by the program to the user, enter age. Here you must be 0 year old. Okay, it means to say no one person can have the negative years, I am to say age. Okay, otherwise it will produce the error. Here you must be as numerical, so user can enter the value also, which it can be in a string, so that's why it will accept only integer. Next one example, student, we can consider the same example we have discussed in a runtime error. So here suppose that a variable is a equals to 90, and then try block I have asked the user to enter the value. This particular line for Python 2.7 and the next one line is for Python 3.0 plus version. Okay, and say case sensitive code, that means sensitive code is inside that c equals to a upon b. So if your user will provide the value which is not 0, it will easily give you the output. Otherwise it will say here is error, that is accept 0 division error. Okay, it according to this category 0 division error, the value will be non-zero. Okay, student. So let's student do it practically. So how to do that? I am going to just do the same thing here. So what we are going to do, student, I am going to, as a user, try, and colon will be enter. You can see that slightly the cursor will be shifted to this one side. This is known as intent. Okay, so now you can just type this one thing. Okay, and same thing you have to type here. Okay, and catch value, accept, zero division error. Okay, enter, and here you will type print, within that your message you will type value of b should be non-zero. Okay, because of the, so here suppose that 2, so it will perform the answer, that is 45. If you provide here value 0, it will say value of b should be what thing, non-zero. Okay, so here you can see that, student, as this one message print when I am going to enter the zero value, otherwise it will directly show me the output. Okay, student, so today we have understand how to handle the exception, what are the different type of errors and example of errors, and last practical and homework assignment.